So hello, welcome back to my channel. As you can see, I already have my base done, but nothing on the eyes, and that's because I want to show you my newest purchase, which is the Pat McGrath Decadence palette. Looking already a little bit grubby because I've used it, and I wanted to show you my favorite techniques and testing some things out together. But first, we're going to start with some swatches I've already prepared. So first up, I have to look at my cheat sheet here. Gold Standard, there, a very, very rich gold. Then we have Inferno, which is a really pretty peach kind of shade, but on a dark base, so it has a lot of depth, but you have that nice peachy sheen. Then we have Blue Blood, which is a burgundy leaning more warm purple. Then Sinful, my favorite shade. And this is a true lamé color. Oh, where is it? There, in the other direction. This is really a lamé. If you don't know what lamé is, it's actually the combination of silver and gold. And she used it a lot in clothing, using gold thread and silver thread together. And then it tricks the eye and creates a new color. So that's that one, Lamy Sinful. Then we have Underworld, which is for me the least impressive shade. It's a navy blue, but it's a little bit more crumbly. It has less impact, less shiny than the others. Then we have Sterling, which is a really bright silver. Lapis Luxury, one of my favorites, a very, very deep, what to call it, turquoise. So really pretty. Then we have, what is it again, Divine Mink, also one of my favorites. It's a gray taupe with a purple and pink shift. Then we have Hedonistic, which is a orange metallic base, for me at least, and shifting fuchsia red. And then we have Enigma, also one of my favorites. Really easy if you just want to have one color on your eyes. This one is really very easy to go to. And next, I actually want to show you some of my favorite color mixes, because that's one of my favorite things about Pat McGrath. I feel like a painter. A lot of her shades you can use wet, and then I just like to go with my wet brush and just like a painter go in there and mix things up. But these metallics really go nicely together, and you can create very, very pretty new made-to-measure colors. And I actually first want to show you my biggest revelation I had. It's the second time I filmed this video. The first time I was playing around with that Sinful shade, really pretty, very unique shade, and I was just looking for a word to describe it, and I came out to lamé. And so my brain started working, and I decided to mix the gold and the silver, what I'm going to do now. And you basically get the same thing. But it's even more shimmery, because in the silver and in the gold there's like tiny micro glittery sparks. So it's practically the same. And what I wanted to test with you, because I know there are quite some people who really are intrigued by that shade, is I want to test it with some other golds and silvers I have, so give me a second. So I gathered some colors. I don't have a lot of gold and silvers actually. So I have a silver here from Julius Place. I think it's from the Magic palette. And a gold also from the Magic palette, also from Juvia's Place. So let's start with that mixing. It's a little mixing finger. Is it really magic? It comes close. It's more gold, as you can see. So I'm going to add a little bit of silver. It comes very close, but it's way less metallic, way less shimmery. But you can get the same tone. It's a little bit deeper as well. And then, do I have anything else that comes close? I did pick out all of my Anastasia palettes, colors. So here in my depotted palette. So I'm going to use a gold from the pyramid palette, prism. And I'm going to mix it, not with a silver, but with a more lilac shade. I have to look where it's from. Sultry Cyborg. So I'm going to try these two. It's definitely not the same. It's more a rosé, a rose gold. It's more of a rose. But it's really pretty. And it's more shimmery than the Juvia's Place mix. And then, do I have any more space on my hand? Next favorite mix is Lapis Luxury with Divine Mink. So I will show you that. And it gives a very nice steel color. Steel blue. I'll show you that way. There we go. Really pretty, pretty, pretty. Then, what else? I basically like to mix everything. So I also like Blue Blood with Inferno, which I will do. It's less, it's a less intense color. Ooh. There we go. And then what else did I try? I think I tried Hedonistic with Inferno as well. Which for me is really good because I am not very... I find Hedonistic doesn't suit me very well. But mixing it with Inferno, you get the... Can I show it? A very awkward angle. You get the red shift, but it's more wearable because of the peach. So I want to try Sinful with Divine Mink. Also very interesting. More of a pewtery color, a little bit of greenishness going on. So there we've had the swatches, and what I want to do now is create a look. And I want to use cream bases on this eye and no cream bases on that eye, because I'm also really curious to see if they actually make a difference, because I often wear cream bases because I find they give a look more depth. But then if you have a really pigmented shadow like here, does it cover everything up? Am I doing all of this trouble for nothing? That's actually the question. So I'm going to use two pencils. Sumi Sky from Shiseido, which is a very vibrant turquoise. And then Makeup Forever and 690. I think this one does not exist anymore, but I think they still have the color, but in another format. And then I want to use another Shiseido, Sango Coral, which doesn't exist anymore either, for your pleasure. So, I'm going to start with the purple on the outer corners. I used the purple as a base in my for my halo eye that I posted on Instagram, and there I found that it brought out the purple of the shadow much more, but I had nothing to compare it to, so this time I want to try one eye with cream and the other without. I'm just going to keep it very simple because I'm also a little bit tired. I've been up since 5 o'clock, and it's, what time is it? 7 in the evening. And I went on an excursion in the woods, in the forest. So I'm a bit tired. So I'm going to start off with the blue blood shade. So first conclusion, this eye definitely looks intenser than this one. So it did stick better. So that's already something. Is it more purple? I would say yes. Yes. Then I'm just going to use my cream color and my bronzy color from my old Narcissist cheek palette. Then I'm going to take my Shiseido Paper Light Cream in Sango Coral, just on my finger, only on this eye. Alright, then we are going to use Inferno. With this one, I see definitely see less of a difference. Then first, I'm going to do what I almost always do, and that is or spritz my shadow with some water or on my brush, or use a glitter glue. But today I'm just going to foil it with my face spray. So I'm going to start with blue blood again, and this I'm going to do on both eyes. Because this is definitely a step I do every time. So if then the end result has no difference with the creams, why bothering doing it if the foiling does the trick? I have to layer more to get the same intensity. The difference isn't very big, but there is still a difference. This eye still is intenser. So I'm going to blend that out a little bit. No, here the peach looks the same. It's just because it is more contrast with the purple that it looks very different, but no. So the purple base is doing great. The peachy one I could just throw away, basically. Then I'm going to use my blue Sumi Sky from Shiseido here. Oh, wrong eye. So we're going to do the test for blue on this eye. Great job. So on top, I'm going to use Lapis Luxury. So the difference here for me is quite big. This, where I got the base, is definitely a lot deeper. And I had to use barely any product to get to intensify the color. There we go. I'm just going to put a little bit of the underworld shade here on the outer part of the lower lash line. There we go. And then last but not least, my inner corner, there I was going to use white. Yes, on this side only. There we go. Give it a slight blend. And I'm going to use Sinful. Surprise. Does it make a difference there? Very difficult to say. I actually prefer the side without the pencil. So, very interesting. So I'm going to put on lashes and then we can just talk a little bit more, discuss a little bit more. There we go. We finished off with some mascara and some lips. I used the MAC Versicolor lip stain in Serial Stain number 114 with MAC Night Moth. So what else do I want to say? This definitely is my favorite Pat McGrath palette. I really find it very shitty of her to make this limited edition every time. It's very... It annoys me a lot. otherwise, you can dupe that one color there, that sinful shade, if you only want to try that color. Otherwise, what else can I say? Concerning the cream bases, the blue one definitely made an effect. Purple one definitely did something. This cream one could have done without. I'm just still keeping it, still using it, makes me happy. And then the white base, I wouldn't use with this particular color because I think it makes it a little bit less shimmery, a little bit less exciting. So what I also want to say is that my favorite combination here is this little quad. So the peachy one, blue blood, divine mink, and lapis luxury. So even if it had only been those four, I would have been very, very happy. So that was it. What do you have to remember from this video? If you have the budget, go for it next time. If you don't have the budget, there are dupes to find, even for me the most unique color. What else do I want to say? I love it that I found a dupe for one of the shades in the same palette. I felt very scientific and very genius. And then otherwise... Oh, I ordered it from the Pat McGrath website and I had to pay 24 euros for covering import taxes. But if you know import taxes, I would have paid more to get this here. So I actually don't know if I would have bought for 250 euros, if it would still be 24 euros to pay, or if it changes depending on the amount you spend on the website. But I'm quite sure I will find out one day. And yeah, that's it, I think. I'm really happy with my purchase. I love the gold packaging. You can see my very professional setup there. It collects fingerprints like a motherfucker, but just take your sleeve and rub it. That helps. So that's it. I will leave you guys there. If you want to see, to have any more inspiration for the palette, you can go on my Instagram page where I have 3 looks up right now. So be my guest. Do not forget to subscribe if you want to see more sporadic videos of me. And have a nice evening. Weekend, I think. Bye.